Oh, only two bonus columns.
This is Vic Viper, T-301. Commencing attack on the enemy.
Okay. Oh no. My power of vaporize. Maybe I'm not okay. PS2 games, but this one is really good. Should have enough bitrate to render that. So the options normally follow you, like they just retrace the path your ship takes. But in Gradius V, there's four different gimmicks available for the options. One of them, like, you can change which direction they shoot in. One of them, you can, like, form a formation shape similar to this, and you can stretch how wide they are. Or, like, how compact they are. You can make them, like, line up right on top of your ship and focus on, like, the firepower. with rotation options, which makes them spin around your ship, which is surprisingly good. Some of the types in this game have a continuous laser instead of this, like, goofy, like, short gray. Like, there's gaps in my laser. The options I've been playing. Okay, so I found the top back by stretching my options up above me. So yeah, I got freeze options. I can hold R1 to block them in the shape they're in, and they move with my ship instead of following me around. So this allows me to reach my options past solid walls and attack places I probably shouldn't be able to. Definitely the best at killing bosses by far, but probably the worst at farming points in the levels, so that's why I've, like, practiced these levels so much to try to compensate for that deficiency. Sakimoto did the music for this game. He also did the music for Breath of Fire 5 Dragon Quarter. And Radiant Silvergun, which has the same director as this game. And Ikaruga, Hiroshi Yuki. It's kind of funny, like, Treasure developed this game. And Treasure is a really good studio. Apparently they were formed out of Konami employees who were tired of making sequels all the time. So then Konami begs them to make Gradius 5, and it's the best Gradius game by far. This name was a boss in Gradius 3. The music that's playing is from Life Force, which you can play on your NES. I think the first video I ever uploaded on the internet was my Life Force No Death run. This would put it on his TAS site. In the days before TAS videos existed, it was just like the only TASes were on his website and other like gameplay videos he just liked. One of them was I can't remember who made it, but it was called like SMB1 Crazy God Technique. Which is just like a task of this guy wall jumping off of everything, and it just looked really silly. I'm like, haha, that has to be a bug. I didn't know about wall jumping back then, though. And now it's like an essential trick in getting like a sub 5 in SMB1. I'll have to see the Toho firing pattern for long. I can just throw my options in front like that. Also a boss in Gradius 3, which was a launch title for the Super Nintendo. Good old Type 1, I can attack even when the doors are closed. about that far apart. If you try to go back here, these angry lasers show up. Force Field has a bigger hitbox than, like on that previous boss there, you can fit between the two lasers, like, you know, there's the gap in the middle there that you can fly through, but without a Force Field, you can fit between these lasers. Well, if you have a Force Field, you can fit through it, but your Force Field will shrink. Got a new idea. There we go. Try something like this. Hey, that works pretty good. Game kind of sucks. There's no Mothman in it. Yeah, a playthrough of this game takes about an hour for you to pause, so don't stay up too late. Thanks for raiding. Look at that, I killed the thing just with missiles. This game was like, you have to use your option mechanics to be smart! Oh yeah, do I? Scrolling downward out of my... How do I use my options to get through the barrier? How about I just fire? I should have asked Freepy before he left. If we did do a relay of normal Musubi, do you want to do the back half or the front half? If you ask me, I think I want to do the front half. I think I'm really good at Nocturne's early game. Or some definition of really good, I guess. Not like there's much you can do. Half and back half. I guess the first half is like Osei. Maybe like a little more after Osei. I guess the sisters are the halfway point. Go up until you see Mothman and Ikebukuro Tunnel. After you see that, you gotta switch players. And if you don't see Mothman, then one person does the whole thing. Concern Froge with Necrosaro hands. We've got more Iron Claw crits. Dude, my Iron Claw missed versus Ball Avatar, and I had to reset. Had to reload. I didn't know it could miss on Ball Avatar. It was kind of like, oops! Finished the turn anyway, and then of course I saw the text. And then on the next try, the Iron Claw crit, and I won with two press turns left. Iron Claw giveth, the Iron Claw taketh. But yeah, that was the only other bad thing that happened was I died to Trumpeter because I went in with the wrong Magatama on. I tried it with Narukami on and realized, oh wait, I don't have anyone to cover my ice weakness. Oops. The actual offensive pick is Miasma, because Makami covers your fire weakness. I'm very glad the Trumpeter is a proper spellcaster and doesn't have shenanigans like Hellfire or Prominence. Like, anything with random targeting, it's always, like, Maragi dying. Always hits everything. Under 11 hours? No, it'd be more like 11:10. Or wait, I finished like 11:11, right? No, 11:14. I think sub 11 would be really hard to push. I had an insanely good early game. Oh wait, I had to reload for Spectre 1. So I could probably save like another 3 or 4 minutes there. My score go up. I get points for destroying regenerating walls. What is the Gradient military paying me for? Alright, I get a break here at the right edge of the wall. Pays to destroy stuff. General Pepper is gonna give me a huge paycheck. Oh, that bug hit my shield. I'm scared. See the orange laser coming from below, sniping me. see what I was going for here, though? Like, if I ride close to the heart there, I can just stay down there and constantly damage the thing and then moves up and down. I can only damage the heart when I take away the shield around it. I can destroy the shield by hitting that eye that's riding on the outside. This part's easy, though. Took it out already. Alright, so the no-death run is toast. But I can still 1cc. I usually don't die until stage 4 or 5. Faster allows you to reshape your options quickly, but also the more speed ups you have, the farther apart your options are, which is really important for the lance-like reach that you can have with Type 1. That said, though, this is probably Type 1's weakest level because, like, there isn't the formation that just works. This level's so chaotic. There, you know, look, there's like rocks fall, everyone dies, there's rocks everywhere. Generally, you want your options forward. Doing what? I don't know, but you just want them forward. For this part, you generally want to be moving opening rather than closing. I mean, like, you can, but then, like, you get power-ups stuck in walls and that kind of thing. Like, right there. Oh, that was dirty. Giant rock, like, sitting at high speed, just right at me. I guess I could have piloted better, though. Big rocks are worth a lot of points, but you gotta be careful. Oh, I already have these things. Okay, I guess I'm rushing force field then. Not gonna mess with that big rock, oh no. Oh, this part can be really lame sometimes. It's possible you can just, like, get trapped. You gotta stay really mobile and keep your options open here. This part's random every time. Worst of all, the points are no good. You can destroy the mines, but they're only worth 120 points. trying to do is destroy the big rocks. Oh no, here he comes. Oh lordy, coming. Okay. Okay, can I get one more power up, please? No, I don't think I will.
What?
This is too far forward. What was that power up I asked for? Got off screen. One diamond bullet on screen and I let it hit me. Classic Shiner. Doesn't matter how much I practice this boss. Okay, I haven't practiced it in a long time, but pretty intuitive. Dirty rock. I died three times at this level. Oh, now I'm going into level 6 with one less option. And I have one speed up? Okay. I have a setup where I need to get all my options straight above me with one speed up short of max, which I think is 4. Let me buy that fourth option first. Let's see if we can get it going. Unlock and spread them out to full size. You should get all 5 of these things. Nice. Wow, I got 2 lives left. 3 lives. 1 extent coming up at 1.8 million. Which I should get on the way to level 7. Stage 6 is like, oh no. I forgot I had to go into that. Stage 6 is like the type 1 killer. really hurts not having a continuous laser in this level.
Thank you. This is a speedrunning stream. Get it over with already, Shiner.
Super NES version, that's for sure. Okay, those are two barriers. I don't want to destroy these front floors, because, well, the other attack patterns are much worse. Okay. There we go. Six in your name means anything, eat it up. That means you're older than me. Not by much, though. Greedy.
I died for sure there.
I know that looked impressive, but this part's actually pretty punishing for Type 1. Look at all the power-ups I had to leave behind. Zunkazub. Two above, two behind, and one below. Out of big five options out of four options. This should cover pretty much everything this whole section throws at you. too much to think about, I guess. I want missiles for this part. Actually, I want speed ups. This. There's gravity wells pulling me towards either wall. I got the middle one. Top is the worst because my missiles always go down. I haven't got the walkers on the roof covered yet. Get the power up later, it's fine. Got it. No, it wouldn't hit me. There's room to hug the left side there. Alright. Awesome. Now I just have to one cycle elephant gear, and I will have a nice swaggy 1cc. There we go. Get that behind me. I'm not gonna get my last speed up. There's actually like some very fine motion in this part. I gave us the power up. I didn't be able to get a backup force field. Actually, I should have bought a double. Oh yeah. I just remembered. I used to do this part with a double. That makes so much sense. Because when all your options are rallied on top of each other, you're already doing really good damage. So you actually just want, like, a little more coverage to get the guys on the ceiling. Just missed my chance to buy it, too. Okay, here we go.
Destroy the core.
It should be dead already. Now I have to wait for it to come back the other way. There we go. Yeah, this part is like... This part's really pointless with a laser. Okay, let's go like this. The big way back EVG. Yeah, the sooner you destroy elephant gear, the more bonus stuff you get. It's not worth a whole lot, but it's your bonus points. The faster you destroy elephant gear, the more points you get for it. Yeah, you should be able to just, like, beat it in one trip. It's that middle section is really dicey, though. I think I need to get my option cluster, like, a little closer to me. Like, that was the right height, but... Yeah, it's, like, awkward when they're too far to the left behind me. Alright, all I have to do is not die three times in stage 8. I finally got a 1cc VOD of this. To show Slurpee did. The game remembers everything my past self did in stage 2. So I can take out all the stuff on the lower half of the ship before my past self does and get all those points again. So I gotta act fast once I get to that part. I did it! I 1cc'd Gradius 5 on stream!
Oh wait, one more challenge. Harder than I thought. Okay.
He's shooting in time to the music of stage 2, but that's not the music that's playing now.
Wait, what?
It desynced! It doesn't count the damage of missiles, I think. What's my final score? Nice. Over 2.6 million in one loop. That's actually pretty good.
I am just a small portion of the Empire Bacterian.
Oh, praise it. Pose like Lakshmi until the end. Gaming feats in one night. That's what I want my stream to be about.